अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर इंग्लिश क्लास। हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप एंड प्रे दैट यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ अल्लाह। सो स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव एंटर्ड आवर 11th वीक एंड आई होप दैट एवरी वीक इज अ लर्निंग वीक फॉर यू। बेटा, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ ग्रामर टॉपिक एंड दैट इज प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट एंड प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कॉन्टिन्यूस। Before starting the lecture, let's set some objectives. Our today's lesson's objectives are that at the end of the lesson, you should be able to recognize present perfect and present continuous tense, and you can use them correctly in your sentences. So are you ready? Let's start the lesson. Before starting my lesson, I want you to answer me the question that what are tenses? Yes, you are quite right. Tenses denote the time of action. That means they tells us about the time of action, that at what time the action took place. They show when the work is done. They are past, present, and future. In English language, we have 12 tenses, but right now we are going to discuss only two, and those are present perfect and present perfect continuous. So let's start the lesson. Before starting the actual topic, let us discuss this chart. This chart is also known as tense chart, in which we came to know about persons like first person, second person and third person. Now, who is the first person? The person who is talking, that means I. And if we have more than one person who is talking, then we use we. Now, to whom I am talking to? And yes, it is you. So, second person talking with is you. And to whom we are talking about? Yes, we will be talking about he, she, it, or any singular noun. So this will become my third person. So this is the chart which we are going to use for our tenses. I hope this chart is clear to you now. Let's start our today's lesson. Present perfect continuous and present perfect tense is our topic for today. So let's see that where we can use these two tenses. We use present perfect continuous tense to emphasize on activity. That means that something, some activity is being going on. For example, he has been repairing the car for 2 hours. That means he is continuing the activity. And when we use present perfect, when we emphasize on result, that means we have completed our task. For example, he has repaired the car. Over here, the person has completed his task, and the task was, of repairing. He has repaired his task and he has given us a result. Let's discuss how to make present perfect tense. Like in the starting the tense chart, we have seen the persons. So, we use have with first person, second person, first person singular, that is we, and third person plural. We use have. And for the negative, we use not as well. And for the third person singular, we use has. And for the negative, we add not. And about the main verb, we use third form of the verb. Okay, which is also known as, it is known as past participle. Let's see one example to make it more clear. Okay, these are the examples. Like, I have left or repaired. Over here, I have used the third form of, leave and repair. Again, you have left, they have left, he has left or repaired. She has left or repaired. Is it clear to you? Let's see it in one more example. As we have discussed earlier, we use present perfect tense when we emphasize the result of an action which is completed now. For example, we have painted the flat. All the rooms are painted now. That means we have given the task to paint the flat rooms and we have successfully completed our task. So we are going to use we have painted the flat. It is quite similar when I ask you students, have you completed your work? And what was your answer? Yes, miss, we have completed our work or we have done our work. Is it clear now? Let's move to present perfect continuous. The starting of the present perfect continuous is the same like present perfect, like we have to use have or has as our helping verb. But as it is a continuous tense, so we are supposed to add ing with our main verb. So what the formula or the basic structure for making present perfect continuous? We use I, you, we, they. We use have, and with the negative sentences we add not, and with he, she, it we use has, and for the negative sentences we use not. This portion is quite similar with your present perfect tense. To make it perfect continuous, we add been with it and verb with ing. Is it clear? Now let's see one more example. In these examples, you can see I have been waiting. I have used been and ing over here. And as it is a perfect tense, so I have used have with I. Again, you have been, they have been. Again, he is the third person singular. So we have used has over here. And to make it continuous, we have used been and with the verb we have added ing. Is it clear? Now let's see some more examples of present continuous tense. Present continuous tense we use when we emphasize the duration of the action which started in the past and now and may or may not be completed by now. That means we have given the task and it is still not completed. For example, we have been painting the flat. That's why it smells. We still have two rooms to paint. That means our task is not ended. It is still continuing. Let's see some one or two more examples to make it more clear. For present perfect, as we have discussed, it means that it gives us a result. For example, Tom has mended his bikes. That means Tom has mended his bike. He has completed his task. And as it is a perfect tense, so we have used has over here with the singular noun. Okay? Now for the present continuous tense, Tom has been mending his bike all day. That means still his action, his activity is going on. He has been doing the work. As it is perfect tense, so we have used has with the singular noun. And it is a perfect continuous, so we have used been with ing. Are these examples clear to you? Let's see some more examples. Tom has lost 50 kilos. Over here, as it is a result that Tom has finally lost 50 kilos weight. He has driven 500 kilometers so far. That means he has completed his task of being going somewhere. The road is wet. The rain has just stopped. The action of rain has been stopped. So we have used has over here to make it present perfect tense. In present perfect continuous, let's see its examples. Tom has been doing going to the gym for last 3 months. Repeated action over a period of time. That means the action of going to the gym has been repeated. She has been reading for 2 days. It has been raining for all day. Is it clear? Now let's see where we can use for and since in perfect tense. Beta, we use for to tell the period of time. We use for plus period of time, and we use number plus time words. For example, 5 minutes, 2 weeks, 6 days, a long time, a while, a half hour. We can use them in sentences as well. We use for in a sentence is like, we have been talking for 30 minutes. Over here, I'm talking about a time period. Certain time period has been given to me. It rained for a week. Again, for a week is telling me a time period, that how long the rain has been falling. I have trained for 2 months. Again, 2 months is telling me a time period. He has been off work for a while. So, are you clear about the using of for? Very good. Now, let's move to the since. We use since when we are talking about the starting point. That means when we start our work. It can be a time, it can be a date as well. For example, we have been waiting here since 2 o'clock. That means it is the starting point where we have starting waiting. Yes, it is for 2 hours. He has been living in Paris since 2008. He has grown since I last saw him. Sarah has been sick since Friday. So, in all these examples, you have seen that we are discussing about the starting point when the action took place. Is it clear? I have provided you this YouTube link. You can watch this YouTube link to make things more clearer to you. Your today's assignment is beta that you have to do the given worksheet properly, and the instructions for the worksheets are that you have to keep your worksheets in a folder. Don't turn or fold your worksheets corners. Write your name and date in the provided space on the worksheet. Use blue ink pen on the worksheet, and don't use remover, whitener, correctener on the worksheet. Is that clear, beta? Let's revise all the things that we have learned. Let's discuss present perfect first. How we can make present perfect? We make it with the subject plus have or has. These two are the helping verbs of present perfect. And we add be, that means verb, and its third form. How we can make the third form? By adding ed in the end of the verb. Now, when we use present perfect, when we describe unfinished time, for example, I have worked as a teacher since 2011. When we refer to indefinite time, I have seen the Eiffel Tower. Over here, I have not mentioned that how many times I have seen the Eiffel Tower. Or I use present perfect when I express experience or result. For example, she has already watched this movie 3 times. Is that clear now? Now let's see present perfect continuous. Now how we can make present perfect continuous? We add subject plus have and has plus been plus verb and ing. For example, they have been learning English for 2 years. For negative sentences, we add not in it. For example, they have not been learning English for 2 years. And for making it a question statement, we take a helping verb in the starting and we make they have been learning English. Have they been learning English for 2 years? Now, when we can use present perfect tense? We use when we express long actions that started in the past and continue until now. For example, I have been living in Ireland for almost 4 years. Express recent action that have clear evidence or results now. For example, her eyes are red because she has been crying all evening. Then we can use present perfect continuous when we are. It is used for shorter and more temporary situations. For example, have they been learning English this week? So this is the lecture for today, and I hope everything is clear to you, and now you are able to use present perfect and perfect continuous tense in your sentences easily. Thank you very much, and Allah Hafiz.